Hello, my YouTube family. We are going to budget out August paychecks 3. Yeah, I can't believe we're already doing paycheck 3 in August already. I'm like, wow. August is my birthday month. It's August 27th. So before you know it, that will be here. And then hubby's birthday is in October. And before you know it, his birthday will be here. And then we have the holidays. So it's going by really, really fast this year. So what we're going to do is, because this is the last weekly August paycheck you're going to see, because starting in September, we are doing a monthly budget. Cash stuff-in, we are going to do the cash stuff-ins because I'm going to pull that money out so we have to cash stuff our sinking funds and our cash envelopes each week. So, but you're only going to see one budget per month, which whatever that budget is, that's the money. I have to break it down into 4 or 5 weeks, how many weeks are in that month. And that's the money I have to pull out to put onto the side so we can cash stuff our, still our cash envelopes and our sinking funds. The bills, I am going to write all that down. That will be with prop money because I do keep that money into the bank. So I will use prop money for that, for food and any of our like mortgage and anything else that we need to pay out that has to stay into the bank. Same thing with our, our emergency fund. I do put some cash in there till I get to $100. And then once I reach 100, then I pull that out and I put prop money in and then we put that in our safe. So we're just going to keep it conservative. 150, that's been working for us. So I'm going to do 150. And then we have our gas, which is going to be 40. We have household. That's going to get 5. Personal care. 5. Pets. It's 10. Hubby is 10, and I'm going to get 10. So add all that up, comes to 40 plus 5 plus 5, 10, 10, comes to $80. Okay. Now we have our sinking funds. And our sinking funds, we are going to do Christmas. And Christmas is going to get 5. Car insurance. Definitely have to get another pen. Car insurance is going to get 10. We have our medical. That's going to be 5. P.O. box is not going to get anything because it's fully funded. It's not due. It's not due until November. So in December is when we'll start up putting money back into our P.O. box. Lawn is going to get 2. And we have our subscriptions. And that's going to get 10. So let's add all that up. We have 5 plus 10. 5, 2, 10. It's $32. Okay. And then we have our savings challenges. That's going to get 10. We have our principal mortgage. And that's going to get 20. And we have our big emergency funds. And that's going to get $8. So Let's see if it comes to 150. So we have 80 plus 32, 10, 20, and 8. Comes to $150. Yeah, so this number has been working for us, 150. If it comes over that, then we do try to put more into our sinking funds and try to put more into our savings challenges. You know, the principal mortgage is something we don't have to do because we do send them almost $45 extra every month to go towards our principal mortgage. This is something that I want to do to try to get it down to pay off the house a little bit quicker. Yeah, I know it's probably going to be a while, you know, but it will say it will take off a couple of months of our actual mature date of when the house will be paid off. So anything that I can put towards that, whether if I can't do the 20, $10, $15. I don't want to go any less than $10. But I'm hoping that this will help. I keep checking it like every couple of months to see where our maturity date is going to be. And it has changed because we bought the house in 2017. We took a 30-year fixed mortgage out. So the house wouldn't be paid off until like 2047. But because we've been paying every month extra on the principal, when we make the mortgage payment and I've been paying a little extra each week, now that's changed from having the house paid off in March of 2047 to having the house paid off in June in 2046. So it does help. I mean, it's not quite a full year, but you know, it does help when you do just send them. You know, if you only got $5 that month to send them, I would put it down on the principal of your mortgage. If you take that $5 each month, 5 times 12 months, you're paying an additional $60 towards the principal of your mortgage. So if you times that $60 a year, and you times that by 30 years, that's $1,800 you're sending them in the 30 years. If your mortgage is only, you know, if it's only, say, like $500 or $600 a month, you're literally paying three and a half more payments on your actual mortgage, you know, on the principal and mortgage. So this, you know, this is how I look at it. Some people might look at it differently, but this is how I look at it. You know, so anything you could put towards your principal of your mortgage helps out in the end where you can get your house paid off quicker. This is how I'm looking at things. But this is August Paycheck 3 budget, so I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a like. If you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you as part of the YouTube family. If you go out, please stay safe and always remember to believe in yourself. I love you all. Take care, everyone. Bye.